Man, well, this was seriously unexpected, and before I even realized what I had, I'd suddenly found myself in a bit of a predicament. I have a new fire ant queen, and she's already started to lay eggs. Now, I'm trying not to panic just yet, but if you've been following this channel for a while, you already know that though things look nice and peaceful inside this queen's founding test tube right now, things will look much more different for this queen fire ant and her growing fire ant colony in the making very, very soon. For the past few days, I've been struggling to decide whether or not we should keep her, let her go, find her a new home somewhere, or pursue some other drastic course of action, like ant euthanasia. I'll explain everything, but either way, we need to seriously talk, guys, and I'd love to hear your opinions and get your help on this. Welcome to the Ants Canada Ant Channel.
Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family.
Enjoy. Alright, AC family, I know some of you might be aware that I already own a massive fire ant colony named the Phoenix Empire on this channel. But before any knee-jerk reactions regarding what we should do with this fire ant queen, please hear me out as I go over our options, my thoughts, and what repercussions we face for each. So please, guys, keep on watching until the end, when we determine the best course of action for this new queen ant I caught. But before I go over my thoughts, let's have a look at her. Here she was just a few days ago when I caught her. A single pregnant queen fire ant, the royal seed to a future fire ant colony. I found her wandering on the ground in Antopia, our yard at the ant house. Totally forgot it was fire ant nuptial flight season. Now, a nuptial flight, you ask? Yes, if you're new to ants, when ants breed, they have what's called a nuptial flight, when virgin queen ants with wings emerge from the nest in a huge ant festival, along with male ants, who are also born with wings. These winged ant reproductives then fly off and mate, after which the males die, and each queen, now fertilized and full of developing eggs, breaks off her wings to embark on a search for a suitable place to start her own colony underground. And that's the stage at which this queen was caught. She was wingless and off on a search for a place to dig a hole to start laying her eggs. I placed her inside this test tube setup, which is what we ant keepers do to incubate our newly caught pregnant queen ants, as it simulates the claustral chamber she would have made in the wild. And it is in here, in this test tube, where she would found her new colony. AC family, look at her. Isn't she amazing? I truly love the color of fire ant queens. Cherry red with accents of black. What should we name her? Let me know in the comments, guys. She's already made herself at home and is having a drink of water from the cotton blocking the water reserve. The nuptial flight must have left her thirsty. Now, I can't imagine what this transition must be like for her. Going from living her entire life in a massive ant colony underground, always taken care of by millions of fire ant sisters, and now suddenly being all alone here in her claustral chamber. But I knew Mother Nature had equipped her with all the tools she needed to fulfill her ultimate destiny. Look at her fat gaster. I knew it wouldn't be long before she would lay her first set of eggs. And you know what, guys? I was right. Lo and behold, after checking up on this queen just 2 days later, this was the amazing sight I saw. Eggs! And a lot of them. Wow, our fire ant queen had clearly been busy over the past 48 hours. AC family, this was it. She had begun the process of colony founding. I believe I can count about 30 or so eggs in there. She constantly licks these eggs clean with her antibiotic saliva to ensure they don't mold or grow foul. She also licks all surfaces and her legs with it so everything remains disinfected. Now guys, what happens from here on in is one of the most beautiful and dramatic things in nature ever. So get this, in a few days, these eggs will hatch into larvae, and I think that larger egg there in the upper corner is about ready to hatch. But what's truly astounding is how the queen feeds them. See that big hump that makes up her back? In there are the great muscles that powered her wings for nuptial flight. And well, she doesn't really need those muscles anymore, since she no longer has wings. So her body is now breaking down all that wing muscle tissue and converting it into a nutritious soup, which she regurgitates and feeds to her first set of larvae. It's kind of like ant milk, I guess, but it isn't produced by mammary glands like in mammals. So let's just call it a cream of wing muscle soup, if you will. The queen herself also subsists off this broken down muscle tissue over the next 2 or 3 weeks, as the larvae grow and mature into pupae, then emerge as the very first set of worker ants, known as the nanitics. This period raising the nanitics to adulthood is super critical because she doesn't have an unlimited supply of this cream of wing muscle soup in her body. So she is banking on these nanitics to survive in order to immediately take over operations of the ant colony by hunting, feeding, and caring for the queen and the brood, expanding the nest, and keeping the claustral chamber tidy. For those of you who followed the Phoenix Empire, the fire ants you see here, through this amazing process of colony founding, you already know this initial stage is truly an amazing thing to witness and be part of. All right, everyone. Now, before I get into what all of you have been waiting for, i.e., deciding what to do with this new queen and her brood, I know a lot of you ant keepers out there are at this exact stage as I am. That is, many of you have already caught your queen ants, placed them in test tube setups, and are tagging me on social media, which I love. Super excited for you guys, especially those of you who are new ant keepers and are housing your first queen ants ever. I just love all of us keeping pet ants together. However, many of you have expressed frustrations over being unable to find a queen ant. And if you are one of these individuals still looking for a queen, don't worry. Let me assure you that ant nuptial flight season just began, and it won't end until about October if you're in North America, Europe, or Asia. Just be sure to watch my many helpful tutorials on this channel on queen ant hunting and identifying, as well as what to do once you catch them. Or you can visit AntsCanada.com and pick up my Ultimate Antkeeping Handbook ebook, which has everything you need to know about antkeeping, including full nuptial flight schedules and care sheet guides on all the commonly kept ant species. You can also find AC test tubes, like this one, specially designed for incubating your newly caught queen ants at founding stage, and Pro AC Ant Farm starter kits that I also use for my ants once the queens have workers, all at AntsCanada.com. And just a note, we ship worldwide from the US and offer full email customer support if you need our help. All right, so here we go, AC family. We have 4 options for this queen fire ant and brood. Keep, release, rehome, or kill. Let's first look over the pros and cons of keeping her. Some of you might feel having 2 pet fire ant colonies on the channel might not be a bad idea. There could be an opportunity for us to learn if we choose this route. For instance, we could find out if this new fire ant colony has a different personality than our Phoenix Empire. If it grows at a different rate, if the workers turn out to be a slightly different color, or if it likes the same food. Perhaps some of you look forward to building another cutting-edge paludarium for the new fire ants once they get big enough. Or perhaps some of you just miss the process of growing an ant colony from just a single queen ant, which I totally understand because I'm the exact same way. There's nothing like growing new ant colonies from scratch. Having a second backup fire ant colony might prove beneficial because, as some of you might know, we're in the midst of completing our ant house in Antopia, an hour away, and our future ant room should be finished in just a few months from now. And though overall this excites me, it also has been causing me anxiety the closer we get to moving date, because I still don't have a plan and feel moving the Ember Islands would be a total logistical nightmare. If God forbid the tank crashes and the fire ants come pouring out during the transport process, at least we could have a backup fire ant colony. This new queen and her future minions, which I could just keep in an ant farm setup until we move in. An AC ant farm setup would be much easier to transport to the new ant house than this massive paludarium. The cons of keeping her? Do you think we're ready to take on a second fire ant colony? We all know this species is a hard species to keep, simply because they're always trying to escape, they eat like monsters, and will deliver some very painful stings when working around them. They're definitely a serious commitment, but I'm willing to take this on if you guys are. And by the way, in case you were wondering, I am not breaking the unwritten ant keeping code of ethics by making this new fire ant colony and the Phoenix Empire go to war. not willing to do that. That's cruel, and it would be such a waste of hard work growing the ant colonies. Option 2, release. This is my least favorite option because fire ants are invasive where I live. I surely don't want to release this queen back in my yard of Antopia, as that would be bad for the ecosystem. So then, where could I release her that would make the least ecological impact, is the question. I don't have an answer to that. Our third option, we rehome her. I could likely find someone in my area willing to take her. I'm sure she'd make an ant keeper very, very happy. Finally, we could opt to humanely kill her. We could proceed with ant euthanasia, simply by sticking her into the freezer, where as a tropical species, she would slowly drift off into a cryogenic sleep and die the moment her hemolymph, the technical term for ant blood, crystallizes into ice. Or we could opt to feed her to my hungry fish, or perhaps to another of my many larger ant colonies. They would also happily polish off her eggs. AC family, this is it. Do please take a quick moment to let me know in the comments which of these four options you would choose for this queen and her brood, and why. I'll read through all your suggestions and assess your reasons and make my final decision this week, to be announced in next week's episode. Whatever happens, I'd like to take this opportunity right now to thank you guys for all your ant love. I never imagined there would ever be a global community of over 4 million of you just as invested in these insects as me. I always felt most of the world sees them as pests that need to be squashed or burned with a magnifying glass, which may still be true, but regardless, here we are gathered every week to look more closely at them and open our hearts and minds to understand why they are such magnificent little creatures. And that, AC family, brings me great hope. I also really appreciate you all for subscribing and for taking the time to participate to help me out with these major ant decisions. Thank you so much. As always, the fate of this queen ant and her future brood is in our hands. Let me know what you guys feel we should do. It's ant love forever. AC family, did you enjoy today's episode? Tune in next week to find out what will be happening to this queen ant and her brood by smashing that subscribe button and bell icon now, and hit all so you get notified at every upload. Also, don't forget to hit the like button every single time, including now. It would really mean a lot to me, guys. Thank you. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here. If you would like to watch extended play footage of the new fire ant queen and her brood. And now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, why are springtails called springtails? Congratulations to Petstream TV, who answered, springtails are called springtails because their bodies have a small spring-like appendage that they use to jump. Congratulations, Petstream TV, you just won a free ultimate ant-keeping handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, what does the queen ant feed her larvae? Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ultimate ant-keeping handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's ant love forever.